Dzień dobry. Witam wszystkich przybyłych.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Let me welcome all the people present here. Let me welcome all the people who have joined us here at the official ceremony of awarding the documents confirming the election of the new MEPs. This ceremony was organized by the National Electoral Commission and the Electoral Office. Let me welcome the representatives of the highest authorities in Poland, the legislative, the executive, and the judiciary. I'd like to welcome the Speaker of the Sejm of the Republic of Poland, Marek Kuchciński.
Pana wicemarszałka Sejmu Rzeczypospolitej Polskiej, pana Ryszarda Terlecki.
I'd also like to welcome Deputy Speaker Ryszard Terlecki.
Pani wicemarszałek Sejmu Rzeczypospolitej Polskiej, pani Małgorzata Kidawy-Błońskiej.
Let me welcome Deputy Speaker, Madam Kidawa-Błońska.
Mateusza Morawieckiego.
Head of the Council of Ministers, our Prime Minister Mateusz Morawiecki, and presidents of the head judiciary authorities, of the Constitutional Tribunal, Madam Julia Przyłębska, and presidents of the Supreme Court, Małgorzata Gersdorf.
Szanowni Państwo, w dniu 26 maja odbyły się w Polsce.
Ladies and gentlemen, on the 26th of May, in Poland, for the first time we held the elections to the European Parliament. The turnout was record high, it was 42.6%. You, and here I'm addressing all the people present here, all the new MEPs, you were elected for the term of office from 2019 to 2024. You will be representing the Polish nation in the European Parliament, a nation that in the past, for over 400 years in the period of the First Republic, was part of the Union with the Grand Duchy of Lithuania. Let us recall 1385, the Krewa Union, Hrole Union, Piotrków Union, and the second half of the 16th century, Sigismund Augustus and the Lublin Union. It is a special period of the Polish history that John Paul II spoke about in 2003, encouraging Polish citizens to express their consent to accede to the EU in a referendum. He said, from the Union of Lublin to the European Union. Here you go to Brussels and Strasbourg to represent our homeland in the Europe of Homelands. The vision of General de Gaulle, one of the architects of the European Community, is being implemented with Poland on board for over 15 years now. Pope John Paul II, in his speech in the European Parliament in Strasbourg on the 11th of October 1988, almost 31 years ago, said, today's Europe can surely enjoy peace and spirit of collaboration. It's a landmark of this period that exists between its nations which have experienced war in the past. Let it be a landmark of time that we have a higher sensitivity towards human rights and the values of democracy. And this gathering is an expression of these values and a guarantor of that. Our strong attachment to these values has to be reaffirmed every single day so that in all circumstances, human dignity and human rights are respected. We trust that it's a fact that the part of Europe that up until now has invested so much in European cooperation is currently looking for its soul, spirit, that will ensure its spiritual cohesion. I think that in this particular area, the Europe you're representing is on the threshold of a new period of maturity, of ripening itself and in its relations towards the rest of the world. A common European structure, which is an expression of free will of the citizens of Europe, not threatening the identity of individual nations, will become a guarantor of the equality of rights of all regions. United peoples of Europe will never allow a situation in which one culture would dominate over others. They will support equal rights of every single individual to enrich others with diversity. All other empires are gone now, the ones that wanted to impose their force on others. Your Europe will become a free association of nations that will allow everyone to benefit from the richness of diversity. Ladies and gentlemen, new MEPs, I would like to cordially congratulate you, and I wish that at least in part, when acting in the European Parliament, you will have the guidelines of John Paul II that I just quoted in front of your eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, now we will formally award the documents confirming the election. My fellow colleagues from the Commission will read out the names of new MEPs. They are in alphabetical order, and I will be awarding you your documents.
Pani poseł Magdalena Adamowicz. Pan poseł Bartosz Adam Arłukowicz. Pan poseł Marek Paweł Balt. Pan poseł Marek Marian Belka. Nie ma. Pan poseł Robert Biedroń. Nie ma. Pan poseł Adam Jerzy Bielan. Pan poseł Joachim Stanisław Brudziński. Pan poseł Jerzy Karol Buzek. Pan poseł Włodzimierz Cimoszewicz. Nie ma. Pan poseł Ryszard Henryk Czarnecki. Pan poseł Jarosław Duda. Pani poseł Anna Elżbieta Fotyga. Pan poseł Tomasz Frankowski. Pani poseł Róża Maria Grafin von Thun-Hohenstein. Pan poseł Andrzej Witold Halicki. Pan poseł Krzysztof Andrzej Hetman. Pani poseł Danuta Maria Hibner. Pan poseł Patryk Tomasz Jaki. Pan poseł Adam Sebastian Jarubas. Pan poseł Krzysztof Jurgiel. Pan poseł Jarosław Kalinowski. Pan poseł Karol Adam Karski. Pani poseł Beata Agnieszka Kępa. Pani poseł Izabela Helena Kloc. Pan poseł Łukasz Marcin Kochut. Pani poseł Ewa Bożena Kopacz.
Pani poseł Joanna Maria Kopcińska. Pan poseł Zdzisław Marek Krasnodębski. pani poseł Elżbieta Małgorzata Kruk. Gratuluję. Pan poseł Zbigniew Krzysztof Kuźmiuk. Pan poseł Ryszard Antoni Legutko. Pan poseł Janusz Antoni Lewandowski. Pan poseł Bogusław Marian Liberacki. Pani poseł Elżbieta Katarzyna Łukacijewska. Pani poseł Beata Mazurek. Pan poseł Leszek Cezary Miller. Pani poseł Angelika Anna Możdżanowska. Pani poseł Janina Maria Ochojska-Okońska. Pan poseł Jan Marian Olbrycht. Pan poseł Tomasz Piotr Poręba. Pani poseł Elżbieta Rafalska. Pan poseł Bogdan Józef Żońca. Pan poseł Jacek Emil Sariusz Wolski.
Gratuluję, panie pośle.
Pan poseł Radosław Tomasz Sikorski. Pani poseł Sylwia Iwona Spurek. Pani poseł Beata Maria Szydło. Pan poseł Dominik Tarczyński.
Gratuluję.
Pan poseł Grzegorz Józef Tobiszowski. Pan poseł Witold Jan Waszczykowski. Pani poseł Jadwiga Maria Wiśniewska. Pani poseł Anna Elżbieta Zalewska.
Gratuluję, panie poseł.
Pan poseł Kosma Tadeusz Złotowski.
Proszę włączyć.
The year 2019 by decree of the Polish Sejm is the year of Stanisław Moniuszko. This year we are celebrating the 200th anniversary of the birthday of this composer, conductor, pedagogue, head of the National Theatre in Warsaw, creator of the Polish opera. In a while we will all be able to listen to Stanisław Moniuszko's output played by the musicians from the Philharmonic in Warsaw.
Szanowni państwo,
ladies and gentlemen,
dorobek kompozytorski
the outputs of Stanisław Moniuszko includes opera songs, cantatas, religious songs, songs for chamber orchestra, for symphonies, operas, chamber operas. It's worth remembering that Stanisław Moniuszko was the author of a book encompassing over 200 songs, the so-called Home Song Book. The word home in the period of Russian censorship emphasized the Polish character of the songs included in the book. In his work, he often used folk and folklore traditions. He was a model patriot, and his songs, grand operas such as Halka, touch upon the core of Polish identity, not only in the text, but also in the music, are still a source of inspiration for many artists. In his times, they created the palette of colors through which Poles were able to render the most beautiful shades of their national identity and feelings towards their homeland. That is why the Polish Sejm, being certain of the particular role played by Moniuszko, declared the year 2019 Stanisław Moniuszko's year. His output will be presented to us by artists from the National Philharmony in Warsaw, Małgorzata Pańko Edery and Arna Marchwińska. Małgorzata is a graduate of the Warsaw Music Academy. She was awarded a Magna Cum Laude Medal. In the Grand Opera, she plays in operas by Tchaikovsky, Puccini, Moniuszko, Tchaikovsky, or Mozart. She's also the leading actress in Ptaszyńska's output, Weinberg works. In the Riga Opera, she sang the role of Carmen by Bizet and Eugeniusz Onegin by Tchaikovsky. Together with the Latvian opera team, she played in Bolshoi in Moscow. She worked with many outstanding directors, including Laco Adamik, Maciej Prus, Mariusz Treliński, or Krzysztof Walikowski. She worked with Gabriel Chmura, Dworzyński, Kasprzyk, Kord, Minkowski, Penderecki, and Witt. She also songs cantates and songs. Anna is a pianist. She graduated from the Frederic Chopin Music Academy in Warsaw, and she also studied at Stanford University under Bronisław Kowala, Jerzy Marchwiński, or Sam Sanders. She's a graduate of numerous prizes and international festivals. She worked with New York City Opera, Metropolitan Opera, and Di Capo Opera, as well as prestigious musical festivals such as the Easter Ludwig van Beethoven Festival. Since 1992, she specializes in chamber orchestra work. She's active not only in Poland but also abroad, for instance in the Kennedy Center. She was also recording music for the Polish radio. She is part of the National Opera in Warsaw since 2010. She's been the head of the soloists division. She's also taking care of young pianists in the Opera Academy. The first song will be Dumka from Jadwiga. Then songs by Moniuszko from his musical output. I hope you enjoy the performance.
Nasza uroczystość dobiega końca.
Ladies and gentlemen, this ceremony has come to an end. Finally, on behalf of the National Electoral Commission, I would like to thank you very, very much. I'd like to thank the representatives of the Polish Parliament, speakers of the Parliament, the Prime Minister, heads of the Supreme Court and the Constitutional Court for being present with us here. Your presence is a proof of the importance of what happened on Sunday. The European elections, we elected our representatives, the Polish team. The nation is like a league. There are different situations. Some play unfair. There are some disqualifications. But if we play in this team, in the national squad, if we play outside of Poland, then the advocates, defense of all individual teams which may have some animosities towards each other, play together. That's my sincerest wish to all the Polish MEPs. I hope that this term of office that is in front of you will, for you, be a period to implement the words of John Paul II that I quoted. I hope that the relations inside this team will be a proof that you're playing fair play and not against each other. This is my sincerest wish, and I hope that I speak on behalf of most of the Polish society. Let me thank you once again for your participation. I'd like to thank the MEPs for coming here. It's just like a wedding reception. You get ready for everyone, and then you have to invite people over. I'm so happy to have so many of you here. Thank you once again very, very much.